What's up, guys? This is Isaiah from Games, and this is episode 80. Ep087 of our Gaimoria Dev stream. The music we got playing right now is from Hyperlight Drifter. I just realized that Disaster Piece released it on his Spotify, so this may or may not mute the YouTube export, but I like the music, so I'm going to have it play. I hope you guys had a good weekend and had a productive weekend, maybe a chill weekend, whatever. I had a very busy weekend. Actually, I had a nice Saturday. All I did was play video games because I worked like crazy all week. Worked till about 2 to 3 a.m. every day last week, just cramming out the animations that I've been needing to do for Aniah. And I have like two or three more I need to do. And we are planning on having a playtest next week Friday. Our first playtest, so that's super exciting. And we're gonna be posting about that on social media, and we're gonna have a sign-up list so people can like put their email in, and then we'll inform them about the playtest and when it's happening, and then send the emails out. So we're gonna have one next week Friday, and then I think we're gonna have another one another 3 weeks later, and then another 3 weeks. So it's something like that. That way we're getting in a bunch of stuff for every playtest. So this week I was supposed to start getting on to some of the pet animations, but because we have the playtest that we're doing that just focuses on Aniah and combat against the enemies with just Aniah, I'm going to just keep working on Anaya's animations and push the pet stuff back a week. So this the stream is just going to be more about more Aniah animations. So the ones that I need to do are for summoning an idle animation, because I have summon and run that I did last week early. So we have her summoning and running, where she's holding her flute out and running. I don't know if I ever showed you guys the polished version of this. So all of her orbs are active, she's running around, her flute's playing, and then she can summon them. And so now what I'm going to do is we need an animation for the transition for when she stops moving, because say she's summoning, you can see right here it just stops her animation completely because we have an animation state that has no animation. Then when we run, it works fine, and then when we stop moving again, it stops again. So the animation I'm going to work on today is what would be here, which is just idle and summon. And then after that, I guess I actually can show you guys how my other animations went that I was working on Friday. So I had her charging animation. See how many animations I have here? This is like probably close to like 40 to 50 animations just for Aniah that I've done in the past several weeks. So 4, 8, 12, 16, 20, 1, 5, 9, 33, 37, 38, 42. Yep, so 42 animations for Aniah so far. And then I'm gonna make another 4 new ones today. That'll put up to 46. Yep, a lot of animations for her. Anyway, so what I'm gonna do, simple. I'm just gonna like cut her legs off here. This is her summoning and running animation. I'm just gonna go through and cut her legs off.
Oof.
And then replace it with her idling lower body. Oh yeah, I was gonna show you guys the other animations. So, she has charging up. You might not be able to see this very well. She's charging her dash attack up, charging it down, left, right, and then she has where it's fully charged, which is the next one. So you can see it plays faster, and it's got this big like blasting star. So that'll play after it is fully charged. So that's a lot of what I was working on Thursday and Friday. And so today, I'm doing this summon an idol. I still have not actually played Hyperlight Drifter. I need to get it, especially now that I'm starting to listen to this. It's got that same haunting, beautiful sound that Fez had, and I love it. And this sound specifically is very Fez. Can tell these are older animations because of how jagged the lines are. Back when I was making these the first time, I didn't know how to get my stuff to look sharp in Unity properly, and the result was I just over sharpened it in Photoshop and now it looks really bad. But it's really only like one animation that has this problem. The rest are all nice and crisp and smooth.
Thank you.
What? Oh my god, that's annoying. All of the selection I made from all these previous frames got deselected somehow. Now I get to reselect them all. Okay, seriously, see that? Something's going on. It's not adding to my selection. Like, my shift key is broken. Thank you. What's up, Raviolio? How's your weekend? What was the temperature like where you're at? There's two doves trying to have sex with each other outside my window. They're very noisy. They sound kind of like high-pitched predators. Kind of creepy how close they sound to a predator. They're like making the click sounds, like can't make the sound, but it's like We have a playtest we're doing in about a week, 2 weeks, a week and a half. On February 3rd, we're going to have our first playtest. We're going to actually host an in-person one at the University of Hawaii. But we're also going to put the build online for people to download and try, and then do a little survey, like an exit survey. So that's really what matters the most, is like your guys' feedback. So if you follow us on Twitter or Facebook or anything, I think tonight we're going to be sending out a picture with some info about how to participate. It's mostly just going to be to sign up for a mailing list, and then we'll just give out all the info and the emails that we send out. So the emails will have like links to the builds, links to the survey, that kind of stuff. So if you want to participate in the playtest, just keep your eyes peeled. And then later this week, whenever I stream either Wednesday or Friday, I'll also bring it up again. And I'll have an actual link that I'll be able to paste in chat at that point to get people signed up to it. Sweet. Do you follow us on any social media? Or do you just, like, follow us on Twitter and that's when you know to get the notification email or something? Okay. Yeah, so you should see it then. Okay. Yeah. Now I gotta duplicate all the clips for this. I have so many animations. Brain's farting. Okay, so I made clips. Now I need to hook up the clips. Sorry, man. Sometimes you just gotta talk to yourself. So I'm trying to think of like a million things at once, and then you kind of stop actually doing things. So this is for her summoning and stationary. I don't know if you guys actually watched me set all this stuff up before, so these are all animation states. I think I've showed it to you, but I haven't actually set it up. So You gotta make all these states, and then you have blend trees based off of input X and Y, and then you gotta have a motion field for every direction, and it creates this kind of like grid here, or this visual. And so you need to put in like, what is the animation gonna be at positive one? So it's gonna be, or positive one Y is gonna be up, and then negative one Y is gonna be down. And then negative 1x will be left, I think. 1x will be right. Then you just have to drag summon idle down, goes to the negative y. Summon idle left goes to the negative x. And idle right goes to the positive x. Summon idle up goes to positive y. So now, this is called a blend tree, where it basically takes your input of X and Y, which is your arrow keys or your control stick, and it reads that and then plays a different animation depending on what the player is inputting. And you can actually get really detailed with this. You can put animations like in between here. So if their input is at like minus 0.5, so you know they're doing like halfway, they're not pushing their control stick all the way over, they can have a walk animation. Or if you do it even shorter, like at 0.5, they can have like a sneaking animation, if that's part of your game mechanics. But for us, it's just up, down, left, right. And that's what we're using for a lot of these. So now I have those clips set up. And I can go back here, and because I duplicated it, they're not actually correct, so I need to fix them. So summon idle down, see, it shows the running one because that's what I duplicated, so I delete these. I have to go to these frames that I made, pull them in. This is her summon idle down. It's kind of all over the place. Get that lined up first. So, sprite editor. So the best way to do this is just get my standard idle down animation. See where her feet is. Watch that. Gotta go to the right. Oh, we have to actually just tweak the pivot. Go up a little bit. That. So that's very, very close. Idle down. In fact, that's so close, I don't think I'm gonna touch it. An idle down. Yeah, it's very close. Okay, so now I just need to line up all the rest of my other stuff. I might keep the fact that her hair moves. Even though she's standing in place, I think the fact that her hair is kind of moving makes it seem like she's doing something magical and there's maybe some, like, aura or wind, you know, kind of blowing around. I might actually just keep that. And end up redrawing. So, especially her torso, like, there's way too much jiggliness going on because I copied it from a run animation. She's got a lot of, like, the creases are doing a lot. And it made sense for when she was, like, moving and running and stuff and the shirt was pulling in all kinds of directions, but for idle, I think it's really good. What I might actually do is copy even more from the idol, not just the legs. I might just copy the whole torso, brace the arms. Let's see how that. I'll probably keep it. Okay, let's try that. Just copy the torso here. I think this might actually be what I need to do. I think that's going to end up being more work than I care to do. I'll just redraw it. Well, we do have a playtest coming up in a week and a half. That would be a great place for a lead user of frustration role. God, this place is so fun. I hate it. It's surprising how many games do that. Make you backtrack. World of Warcraft was notorious for that in its early versions. Oh man, it was so bad. Spent so much time running back and forth. I hated it. Like, couldn't you have just given this to me when I was here last time? No? Okay. So then you turn that quest in or whatever and you go to where you have to go and then they send you back to the same town. They tell you to go back to the other place. Fabulous PR. Yeah, there will be no back and forth in Gaimoria. You just go wherever you want. And you just progress further by going further. Don't have to go back to find a key or anything. Oh yeah. We all know good games are long games, right? We don't want an 8-hour masterpiece, we want an 80-hour piece of shit. Because quantity is quality. It's funny how many of these things are actually, like, truth in the AAA game industry. Yep. Like, these things you're joking about are not actually jokes. It's really sad. Well, you've got a fantastic career in the AAA industry, then. Get them into loops, reward loops. I cherish. I like the quotations. Or be fun and last longer. I have a feeling my frames here are not in the right order. Because every time I'm tweaking this frame, it's not actually getting changed. Let's just do something crazy with it and see what happens. I guess it does change. I don't know, it just seems unresponsive. Was Remy in chat? He's just quiet and hanging out. Yeah, it's just a lot of copy-paste. Just kind of merging other things together. Yeah, it'd be nice. I think we're gonna... That'd be mostly supplemental. Because it'd be... I think it'd be good to have it go with Anna's club as well at the UH, so... I think the one at UH might be a little more structured, because people are kind of coming and knowing what they're getting into, but the one at Manifest may be a little more relaxed. Plus, the nice thing about being at Manifest, we can drink, whereas at UH we cannot, you know, it's a university. I might just have to put my beer into my, my hydro flask. But, yeah, at Manifest, we can, like, just hang out and drink and, like, have fun. So, yeah, that'd be cool. I'll probably talk to Anna and Peter and Sam about that this week. Get a good weekend for playtesting. Did you see my link in Slack about the... Let me see. In the code design page, I have the playtest survey. Could you just do like a quick run through it and see if it seems okay to you? I think it's mostly good. Oh, I can actually test this animation in game. We have the parameters hooked up correctly. So that's nice. I forgot about that. When I get these things all lined up correctly, I will actually be able to, like, press play and kind of test and make sure they all look correct. Whereas I can't do that with the dash attack yet, because I made the parameters, but we need code to read the parameters first. Yeah, I'll show it soon. I'm just getting these animations lined up first. Music is spooky. Spooky five me. Sub Sage 26262. You haven't been around in weeks. And you still need to tell me what you want for your NPC. I've been waiting for a definitive answer from you. Last I heard, you said something. Yeah, you're figuring out which animal and colors, so you gotta tell me so I can make it. Are you excited for that? Get out of the military? Yeah, scary's not bad though. Everything I've done in life has been pretty scary. I mean, I left the AAA industry making very good amounts of money to get down to making 500 bucks a month just barely supporting us to work on this, and that's pretty terrifying. Everything I've done in life is terrifying, but you get out of your comfort zone and push yourself, and after a while, you're like, you know what, I'm glad I made that decision. So, terrifying is not a bad thing. It's just a part of life. Yeah, I can. If that's what you want, then that's what I'll do. We had that email chain started. I think the thing was you... No, I'll make them fit. I needed the colors, though. Your top three favorite colors. I think that's what I was waiting on, more so. Because you could make them like a normal draft color if you want, but... You could also, you know, say, oh, I actually like green, silver, and brown, or, you know, whatever your top three colors are, and I can edit his color palette to follow that. So, yeah, I just need your three colors. Why did this completely break? Email it to me so that way I have, four. Wait, what? 23, 24. What is going on? 19, 20. Where'd my 21 frame go? I literally just lost frame 21 out of nowhere. Frame 21 is the size of a pixel somewhere in this sprite sheet. But where? Oh my god, this is stupid. I just delete this one. Great. Now I gotta go on Google and figure out what the hell happened here. I think I put in the wrong number, and then it just like exploded my slice, and now it is somewhere the size of a pixel in my entire sprite sheet. I don't have any idea where. I was editing the Y. It's now. Lost. Let's see. Literally have no idea where my... It is the size of 0 pixels by 394 pixels. I don't know how to delete that. And I can't find that slice. Can't delete it. To cycle my sprite selection. This is gonna drive me crazy. I don't know how I could possibly even select it. Selecting these does not select it in this sprite editor. Can't delete it. I have to manually select a slice to edit it. Aha, that's how it works. So it's way over here. Apparently this shows like where the slices are better. So if I can select it. All right, we're in business. Come on. There we go. Okay. So let's see. 393, 290, 410. so now I can actually fix it. So she's kind of tooting on her doot here, so now I can actually, I think I should actually be able to play with this because I have the animation states in, so let's take a look. So she's summoning, yeah, see, it works. And she's like running and summoning, then it goes right to this one. Her sprite size seems to shrink though. So I think she should not be 265, or 275. Be 275? X, her whole body shrinks, so that is an import issue. I also need to move her sprites all up a bit. good. So I had to move it by 0.2 Y. Yes, it is, and we are actually probably going to have a playtest by Friday next week. So if you follow us on Facebook or Twitter or anything, keep your eyes peeled. I think later tonight we're going to be posting an image on how to sign up through our playtest mailing list, and then through that playtest mailing list is how we're going to get people signed up for our playtests, and I think our first one should be Friday next week. So if you're interested in just kind of running around and testing stuff out, then make sure you're looking for that and sign up for it. Thank you. Well, I'll see you later, dude. Good luck on your transition to civilian life. Well, I mean, you probably already have civilian life, but you know what I mean. So what I'm doing right now is I'm trying to line up Aniah's head in between her run and her idol summoning animations so that there's not a weird pop. And I've just fixed most of them. The only one that has a weird pop now is her running up and then stopping and idling up. Her head drops a lot, and I think what the problem is because her up animations are kind of the length of her body's extended because her legs kick out a lot from running. I need to actually not edit this animation, but this pivot. I need to edit the pivot of the running animation because it's too high. So I need to maybe drop the pivot down of that a little bit. Maybe. Actually, you know what I'll do is, I think maybe I need to adjust my sprite sheet here. I think that's actually what the problem is. Select all of these. Them up, actually. Yeah, that's better. So now her head doesn't drop so low when she goes from the run to the idle. I think the only thing now is I need to edit the transition time, so there's a faster period. See, because she'll like take a couple steps before I stop moving, before it actually goes. So even though I'm only tapping down, it takes a long time for us to get to the idle one. And what that is an issue with transition time. So I need to edit the transition time from running to here. No, wait. It says has no exit time, that's why. I should have fixed it. There we go. So now she'll automatically just hop her animation over. It's really subtle. You guys might not even be able to see it in the stream, but I think I'm gonna also edit the X pivot here, because she's getting a weird pop forward. I don't want that. It's not so bad here, it's just this one popping forward really bad. So her idle summon left, go over. Disabled. So I need to animation window. I need to move my pivot X to the left more, so or 0. Try that. There we go. So now we don't have a weird pop when she's running. She stops running. She doesn't, like, pop forward all of a sudden. Then I also saw that I needed to edit the transition from idle to summoning stationary. Does not have exit time, transition is 0.1. So I need to set this transition duration. So running. It's also. Okay, so I think that looks mostly good. So, run to here. So she just busted out, that's good. Then, running, busted out, that's good. So she's just like, pulls her flute out immediately, which is what I want. And she immediately transitions to the idle summoning, and you're not moving. So now that's good. So what I'm actually gonna do is just clean it up and finish it. At least the line work. I don't know if I have time to do the colors. Well, actually, I might be able to get the flats in. I mean, like, her legs are kind of jagged, but I don't think people will notice in the greater scheme of things, so. Whatever. Just leave it. So. Gonna clean up how they connect. Oh, fuck it. I'll just redraw it. I don't care. It's not gonna take that long. Yeah, I can show you. The one I bought too was way cheaper than buying the Ergotron brand name one. I think the Ergotron was like $300. But I think this one was like $100. I'll just look when you get home. Thank you. All right, I gotta pee. I'll be right back. I think I exhausted that playlist. Let's go to Fizz. Fizz is good. Way down the list. Done a lot of stuff. How old is Fizz? Be like 2008. Added it late. They moved it. Yeah, they added it late. Thank you for the follow, ARHAdrian17. I honestly still think that Disaster Piece's best work is on Fez. There's a reason why it's what got him really popular. I think his work is just a little more melodious on Fez, and I think his other stuff might be a little too abstract. But with Fez, like, there's a very noticeable melody that you can kind of follow. And if there's no melody, you just, it gets lost in abstraction. And that's what I noticed when I was listening to the Hyperlight Drifter soundtrack, is the songs that were really good had a very noticeable melody, and it was like the title screen and then there's like two others, but the rest was just really abstract, like almost like test tracks that never got finished. I'm wondering if that's because people allow too much creative control and they don't actually direct the music for their game very much. Like, they're just kind of like, oh, we just want you to do the music and do whatever you want. So I don't know if that's what's happening or that's how people actually want their music. But personally, I think his work is best in Fez. I think it's because each of the songs are much more memorable. So you can tell this song too also has like a very distinct melody.
Thank you.
Alright guys, well, I think that's enough for today. It's actually been a really long stream, I think almost like 3 hours or so. So, I'll pick up the stream again either Wednesday or Saturday or something, or not Saturday, Wednesday or Friday. So, I will see you guys then.